Hello guys and welcome! Today I will share everything there is to know about transforming villages and reveal a few tips and tricks on how you can transform a village. We are right now at a desert village, and not just any desert village, a very very strange one that only has for some reason three buildings. There's even like two buildings growing into each other. We have here like a blacksmithing house that's growing into a small regular house. That's a very, very, very tiny village. So yeah, when it comes to transforming villages, make sure you find the village that you also enjoy from the location. Like, do you want to transform a village that's near to the ocean, like near to the sea, like here? Then this could be yours. Do you want a village where you don't need to do so much work or rework? Then pick one like this with just few buildings where you can add a lot yourself, and then you don't need to break old buildings. So yeah. Let me first of all show you one of the desert villages that I have transformed in the past. Yes, this is one of the villages I've transformed, a desert village. And here's a huge wall, and what you will find behind this wall is really, really interesting. It actually took me eternity building here. And we even have like a redstone gate, like you can do crazy things with villages. And yeah, let's open this and let me show you what I did here. So you can already see there are a lot of really, really large buildings, and I completely changed this desert village. Like somewhere over there was the original village, but all those builds, even this cow farm, this regular farm here, and all those buildings, they were added by me. Even this one I've added. And this bell wasn't there, I moved this bell. So once while I was like traveling through the desert, I found this really, really interesting tiny... This was also like with just like 5-6 buildings, I think only those over there. This tiny nice desert village here, somewhere here was the bell. And I've decided, hey Marcel, why not change this whole village into a freaking walled kingdom? And that's exactly what we did. There's like a whole Let's Play series to that on my channel. And we built a wall there together. Maybe some of you remember this. And we started like customizing a lot. We added like first of all like smaller buildings, like this small fisherman house here with this little boat here. And we were like fishing here for some time. And we even added like really, really spectacular buildings to this village, like the desert palace over there. Let me actually show you the best building of this transformation project. Like here, we built a freaking palace. Like, look at this. Like, just when you enter here, we have like this freaking nice entrance here. We have for some reason a chicken that doesn't belong here. Or maybe does belong here. I don't remember why there's a chicken. And yeah, we customized a lot. We have like a freaking oasis here in the desert. Usually you don't see so much green here, trees and stuff, right? Like, that's not typical for the desert, right? We've made like some freaking kind of shooting stand here with a Fletcher, as you're offering. Okay, those are bad trades. When we enter here, this looks actually crazy spectacular. Like, look at this. So many villagers work in here. And upstairs is a very, very nice library. Ah, my cat. I actually forgot this cat here. I need to move this one still. I'll do this later. Yeah, you can do crazy stuff with already existing villages. We have like, we've built here for, was it like weeks? I don't know how long it took, but it took like eternity to build this. But it's such a nice big home here. So many beds. I think half of them are already occupied, maybe even more. And we even have like a freaking market here. What's this librarian doing here in the corner? Oh my gosh. So yeah, let me quickly show you the market that we also added to this desert village. Oh yeah, here are two weapons misworking. Let's go to the market before it's too late. Hope they're still there. Because it's gathering time now. They're all gathering up there. So here's the market, but they all went to the gathering point where the bell is. Oh, one is still here. What's he offering? What's he offering? Okay. Need to level him up still for diamond gear, but yeah, this wasn't here. There's a buildings added by me. And as you guys can see, I did stick to the theme of sandstone. And there's a reason on why you should always stick to the theme of a certain village. And look at this population of this transformed villages. Like, you would never see a village have so many villagers. And some of them are actually like leveled up and stuff. Like, look at this. We have protection 4 here, for example. Like, look at this. We have some really great enchants here. And oh, it's lovemaking time. Like, they're gonna. Wow, this is a baby booming village here. I haven't been here for weeks, to be honest. So yeah, a lot changed here when it comes to population, because I don't remember here being so many villagers. And I only added like a couple of buildings, or like this building here. It's one I've also added. Very simple, but it's nice. So yeah, let's get back to this other desert village that we will transform a bit today. As you guys saw earlier, in the village transformation that I did to the desert village in the desert kingdom, I was also sticking to the theme of using smooth stone. Like smooth sandstone. It's very, very important to find a matching color to a matching biome. For example, if you're building in the desert, you want to mostly use like warm colors and nothing too cold, right? So what you probably want to do is you want to use something like smooth sandstone. Terracotta also works well. I wouldn't go with wood, because if you use wood, for example, to transform a desert village, like, it's a bit unrealistic, right? Because the desert is freaking burning hot. So if you use, for example, wood, you would expect this to burn. I mean, it does burn in Minecraft, but in real life, if you have like a wooden house in the middle of the desert, like the Sahara Desert, for example, this building will be on fire from all the heat and sunlight, right? So if you want to have like a realistic feeling, go with something that would match a biome. It would also look really strange if someone starts building with birch wood, like birch planks, for example, in the taiga. So you always want to have a color that fits the biome, right? So if we are transforming our desert village, we will stick to that color with terracotta or smooth stone. So yeah, what I always recommend to do first of all is, like, make sure you have, of course, a village where you like the location, and then make like a rough layout of where you want houses to be. That's especially important if you do like a walled village, like we did in desert. You want to know where is the last house gonna be. So look at this area and make a rough idea on how big you want this to be. For example, let's say we want here to be, let's do something that's outstanding here. Here to be the corner of this project. So we just gotta put a few blocks here, and let's say behind this sand mountain, somewhere those cactuses are, will also be a border of where the village will end. So we place there some blocks. Somewhere over there, before this cave starts, will be some blocks. And somewhere over there. It doesn't matter if it's like completely in line with each other, because you just go from corner to corner. It's just like roughly where you want your border to be, right? For example. Especially if you do like a walled kingdom like I did, like a walled village. But even if not, you still want to know a rough layout of where stuff will be. So yeah, somewhere over there, we're going to add a simple extra house. This will be like a farmer's house. So what we first of all need to do, and I always recommend this, make first the layout of the building. You can always just break the blocks and replace it with something like terracotta or something else, for example, here for the corners, right? So we're going to have like a bit of a balcony here or something. So here will be the entrance. Yeah, I think I would, yeah, I'll put here the entrance. Then we are going by three blocks here. There will be a small window. And here this will lead to a garden. And yeah, the layout is really, really important when it comes to buildings. What I also recommend is, of course, we make the corners different. We're going to use some cut sandstone for that. So yeah, now we have the whole layout done. We see everything here. So this will be the entrance. This will have just one floor. We're having a height of 4 blocks for the rooms. And yeah, let's finish this building. So now we have this building complete, at least from the whole building itself. And now what's really important is we will make like a really, really nice indoors area. So somewhere over there will be the door. You don't need to stick to the wood or the materials used in a village. When I said earlier, if you transform a village, I always recommend to use a color that is fitting. I mean, make at least 50 or 60% of your building out of that material. You of course can use different things, like different doors. Like you don't need to stick to jungle doors, for example. You could just use spruce, for example. Looks also really, really nice. And what you also can do then, you can use even more spruce, for example, over this door. We put for example here, for the entrance, some stairs like that. What you also can do, and that looks really, 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 really great, you can use some spruce buttons, for example, because I've seen that they use this in villages, and for example place them all around the building like that. This will look really, really, really great. Oh yeah, that looks way better. Now here will be a door as well. And now we completely can focus on the indoors area. Oh, a villager's already here. So now we have like this nice little carpet here. Let's double this. And now we have like this nice kind of like carpet here with the terracotta. What we will also add here is, of course, some lanterns, because it can't be dark here, otherwise like stuff will spawn. Let's also get a chain. And right when we enter here, there will be one here and one here. Okay, didn't get attached to the chain. Why it doesn't attach to the chain here? Okay, now, eh? Okay, now it worked. I'm now almost done with the indoors area, and I've decided to actually get rid of the lanterns here with the chain, and instead we are going to use here some stairs, and this will be like our window shelf, and we're just gonna put the lantern on here. Like the cool thing about lanterns as a light source is it even looks good on like bookshelves and like stairs like that. Like you could do it like that, right, and let it like hang from the top like here, and it's really, really nice. But you can also just put it on some objects, right? Here we're gonna add like a little furnace. This furnace will also have a cobblestone wall, and where is it? Here it is. So one cobblestone block, and then here. Nice. And very, very important, if you are placing down beds in a village, right, and you want like your villagers to breed, make sure there's always at least a space of 2 blocks above the bed. You need this for the villagers to detect this as a bed also made for breeding, right? Because like those baby villagers, they will jump up by 1 block and their size is 1 block. So in order for them to be able to jump on the bed, you need an additional block. So you need 2 blocks of space. It's very, very important. So make sure your buildings are high enough. Like I always recommend, especially if you're like working with like trapdoors for holders for like maybe plants or like barrels like here, always go for a height of 4 blocks at least for a house. You could go with 3 blocks and just not use any trapdoors for decoration here and just have like a bit of a, like a smaller building. That works as well. So that would basically mean that our ceiling would already be here. That would also work because you still have 2 blocks above the bed. But you really, really need this for the villagers to become willing. It's very, 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 very important. So yeah, I like the overall feeling when we enter this building. I think that really looks nice here, right? It turned out pretty well, like a little nice comfortable home here. We even have like a furnace here, so we could like grill something, or the villagers could. And make sure that the light level is good also outdoors. Let me show you a little trick for like, for example, street lamps. And this one is like really, really nice if you have already made it to the Nether. Let me show you like a little trick with shroom light. I actually love doing this in villages. So you could also make like a street lamp by just putting 2 fences down like that. Then you put like a shroom light on top, and then you just place trapdoor around it. I think it looks actually pretty nice. So now if it's dark, you have a light here. By the way, we're also gonna add our garden here. So here will be a stone wall. Let's see, yep, here. And here will be a gate. Let's go for acacia here as well, because indoors I've used acacia. And I think acacia looks really, really great in the desert. Like, it really fits, right, from the color. Because like I said, if you're building in the desert or in a certain biome, stick to the theme. If you're building, for example, in the taiga and you're transforming a taiga village, use stone and wood. But don't use like sandstone or anything like that, because that will look strange. Same with birch. So try to find something that matches. We also could do, we could also put here a shroom light, for example. You could also use a torch. Doesn't really matter. We put like trapdoors around it. But I personally think a torch would look better. Let's get rid of this. Let's place torch here. And we're gonna have like a little garden here, so let's get some dirt blocks. We need rose bushes. Let's place those here. And I need a diamond hoe, and we need some beetroot. Unfortunately, there are no tomatoes, otherwise I would grow tomatoes here. And I'm still gonna add like a nice sitting area here. One moment. So here will be two stairs. We'll place signs on the side. Ooh, this is really, really nice. We also could do... Oh, look at this. We have a little nice garden. We're also going to make the top look better by placing every second block another cut sandstone. Okay, now our first added house is done. And what we also will do here, use some spruce trapdoors. We are going to place the spruce trapdoors to every window as window shutters. Here, one here. Oh no, I messed up. Okay, now very, very important. We have this nice extra house here that we've added to the village. And we have like a double bed here. I always recommend to use double beds if you're transforming villages, because you get to have a population by an additional two villagers. And you're saving a lot of space with double beds. Like if you wanted to, you could do like single beds and just randomly place them somewhere, right? And you have like beds everywhere. Like that works as well. But... it looks so weird, so I always recommend to go with like double beds and not have like one bed here and here. Just find like one corner and add there like a double bed and maybe like a second corner. But don't have like one bed here and one bed here, like a single one. This looks a bit strange otherwise, like, yeah. So make sure you use a lot of double beds when you're transforming villages. It just makes stuff so much easier. And now if you want your villagers to breed, they need to have at least, for example, 12 carrots or potatoes in their inventory to become willing. So we're just gonna throw a couple of stacks around of carrots. You can do the same with like beetroot and also with potatoes. And they will like share it with each other and then they will become willing. What you also can do if you're worried about the detection radius, you can put like beds near to the gathering point. So if there's a bell, for example, over here, and you're like transforming a village and you're worried that they won't find your new buildings like here, just place beds down near to the bell. And here was a freaking success. We have an additional baby villager. And I'm not sure if this was because of the new beds that we added to the bell or because they're actually detecting this building. But then again, this new building, this new little farmer house, is very, very near to the gathering point, right? As you guys can see, there's a big difference in building skill between the naturally spawned building and our little farmer house we built here. This one looks by worlds better. And even if we enter here indoors, this is a very professional, nice looking home here. If you wanted to, we could even add like some more. We could add like a painting here, for example. And that's a little trick if you want to have like a certain size of a painting. Just make sure you have some blocks that interrupt it. And now we have a nice skeleton painting. We have some art here now going on as well. This is a nice comfortable home that we made here. Okay, we are right now back to the Plains Kingdom, my latest village transformation project. And here I have added tons of builds. And this one is even bigger than the Desert Kingdom. Like, we have huge buildings here and a lot of huge buildings. Even over there we have like a freaking tower that we are currently building on. And even like a hunter's house here. It also looks quite nice indoors. And what is this Fletcher doing here? Why is he standing around here? Should I be worried? And what's also really, really important, if you're transforming villages, make sure you also find decorations, not just for like the house, but also for like outdoors. Here we have this little sort of tent with a sitting area. We have like a freaking shooting stand outdoors. And I think this is something that's also very, very important when it comes to transforming villages, to just take out more of the look of a village and make it overall look more dynamic, more interesting, more cool. Just add stuff outdoors as well, be it like cool looking farms, be it like shooting stands, you can even like freaking statues. Like, if you wanted to, you can transform like a plains village or whatever village or savannah village, in the middle of it place like a huge statue that's like resembling your character or something. It's kind of like you are the king of this. Maybe like a freaking bee house. Like, there are tons of builds, and I hope I'm inspiring you today with this video and you get some cool ideas of what you can add to your villages and how you can make them look nicer. And if you're making like very, very, very huge village transformation projects like I did here, make also sure to use multiple bells. I wouldn't just use one bell because they will not find it. Like, the Desert Kingdom isn't that huge. It was one of my like earlier village transformation projects, so I'm just using one bell. But in this project here, the Plains Kingdom, I'm using two belts because everything is quite far and we have tons of really, really huge buildings that occupy like a lot of space, like this farmhouse here or this huge library we have over there. So if you have like tons of large buildings in a big area and you want your villagers to gather, use the bell to make them gather, because the cool thing about the bell in Minecraft is that villagers use them to gather. Like, for this library and all the workers here and all those librarians that we can find in this library that we built, we're using the bell on the left side of the kingdom, while the farmers and the cartographers have the bell on the right side of this. And if it's gathering time and I can't find like my villagers, right, I would just go to the bell and I can find all the villagers. It's just so cool to transform villages, because not only does it give life to your game and you have like friendly NPCs that you can have some interaction with, like trading, and you can get some cool and enchanted books, for example, or you can even trade for some diamond armor or diamond weapons and some cool tools and extras. But you also make your home feel like a home and you add life to it. And if you look at like other RPG games and you add some life to your home, your Minecraft base, for example, if you like build it, for example, where a village is, like, this feels more like home. And if you look like certain RPG games, for example, like Diablo 3 or even like Zelda games or any kind of game, you always have in each action adventure RPG game, you have some sort of city where you return to after your adventures, right? And you have like those friendly NPCs that give you like missions or that you can trade with. You have like shops, and it's just nice to have that as well in Minecraft. And villagers offer this kind of experience to players. So it just makes sense to transform villages and create some really, really nice homes, get some trading going on. Ooh, the breeding here was a success. We have tons of smiths here now. Nice. They're not offering any good. So yeah, so this is the latest village transformation project that I'm working on, the Plains Village, and it turned out pretty well. There are still a lot of more buildings that we are adding, and we are currently building on like this nice villager house over there. So yeah, I would say it's definitely worth exploring and finding cool villages and then transforming them. Village transformation is just so much fun, and you can just do so many crazy builds here and try out new things and have your buildings be occupied by villagers instead of them being empty standalone buildings. So yeah, I hope this guide was useful for you and I was able to give you some advice on how to transform a village, what kind of color themes you should stick with according to biomes, how to build indoors and decorate it, and how high the space should be between the bed and the ceiling, because make sure you always have at least 2 blocks, otherwise your villagers won't breed. And yeah, if you guys haven't subscribed already, please consider subscribing. That would really mean a lot to me. And don't forget to hit that notification bell so you don't miss out any new video. And I'd also really appreciate if you smash that like button. I wish everyone a wonderful day. I will see you guys next time.